Hey coach, it's Coach Simpson here. Appreciate you tuning to my YouTube channel. This channel's got lots of different information, ranging from my style of offense to different drills. Feel free to search around and hopefully you'll find what you're looking for. This video is specific to an offensive line drill, and not just that, but specific to teaching the down block. And not only that, but specific to teaching the down block at the first level in our offense. We are a shotgun wing T based offense, although a lot of the ways we teach down blocking probably would work in any type of pin pull or even a power type of scheme, because essentially we're all trying to do the same thing. We're trying to down block. You know, for us, most of the time if we're down blocking, we're running either buck sweep, could be running counter, or we run a play we call Trojan where we hit a little bit wider, but we're just pin and pull. So that's when this block is going to happen. You know, this is the way we want to teach, starting out early with our kids, and then we progress it as the season goes on, maybe throw in some more elements. You know, I think I've got video and different things on this on my website over at fbcoachsimpson.com, where you can actually get some of the O-line kind of drill stuff. I've got a whole O-line drill book over there if you want to go in more depth on this drill and like 20 other drills that we do. But so the first thing we're going to do is the setup of the drill. You know, for us, I'm not a big person of having 30 kids stand around and watch two kids do a drill. So we like this drill a lot because once we teach it, we can essentially fill up the whole end zone and everybody's working. So partner drill, so you partner up. Okay, for us, a down block, we're gonna offset right or left because we're obviously down blocking. First level defender. So for us, a first level defender is a defensive lineman or a walk-up linebacker, anybody who is basically on the first level of the defense. We do a little bit different drill for a second level down block that I may do in a future video. But for this is the offensive line, okay? The defensive line is basically the partner is standing here, okay? And then the coach is back here working with it. Depending on how many kids we have, you know, by the end of the year, a lot of times this may be, you know, 25 kids that are going through this drill and getting coached up. And we try to section them off by position if we can, or by ability level if we can, or by size if we can. Although that's not super important because again, we're just stressing the technique of this drill. Okay, so for us, we are wanting to down block this defensive lineman. So we are a shotgun wing T, so it's a little bit different than the old school shoulder blocking of the wing T. We want that physical nature, but we also understand that our plays being in the gun are going to develop a little bit slower, so we have to kind of tweak them a little bit. We do teach 6-inch first two steps. You know, the last thing we want on a down block is for either our lineman to get overextended here, you know, you can't see my feet, but too wide, or to get their feet too narrow where they can get pushed off. So we want the first two steps to be 6 inches. We do want to allow them to start turning their body, okay, as they attack the defensive lineman. We want contact with our shoulder. We teach the first part of this to try to get our head across, or head to the belly, and bring our shoulder across. That's where we'd like that contact. And then we want to bring the outside hand. So in this case, if we're down blocking this way, when we're first teaching it, we want our right shoulder to make contact with our head in the belly of that defensive player, and the hip of that defensive player. And then we want to bring that right hand with us to kind of seal the block. Okay, that's the base way we're going to teach this. A lot of times you'll see us, offensive lineman may be over here, and I'm his partner, and I'll keep my hand up. We don't want their heads coming above. You know, we want that head in contact in this section. So we're working on leverage and staying low. We do have some oversized PVC pipe homemade chutes that we've made. I think I've got some drills on here, how we do hurdle drill that we can use in this drill. But it's a lot simpler a lot of times to have that defensive lineman just kind of give him an aiming point where we're wanting to make contact. As we progress the drill, so the first part, it'll be one step freeze. One step, whistle, second step, freeze. And then we'll run the drill all the way through where it's one, two, and then we want to run our feet. We actually turn our rear end. So we actually want to make contact here and turn our butt to the end zone. We are not as concerned with penetration as we are with sealing the defender. Because again, we are in the gun, so that block has to be held longer. There are a few adjustments that we do make, depending on game plan. You know, we talk first thing about if we're scouting an opponent. One, are they an upfield player or are they kind of a down the line, play with their hands, anchor technique? Most defenses, you can have lots of different things you do, but when you break it down, they're either trying to get penetration or they're trying to play down the line. Both are good defenses. We prefer, you know, a lot of times you see those upfield teams because it's an easier block if you're quick enough and you make the adjustments. But we have to be prepared to handle both. So if we're going to play an upfield defensive team, so we're going to go ahead and simulate this week of, all right, we're playing a team, they're really working on getting penetration, they're really quick off the ball, all that stuff, okay? We're going to run the same drill, and the coach is here. When he says go, this partner is going to walk forward, which changes our angle. Now we really want to emphasize bringing our shoulder across or bringing our head across, hitting with our outside shoulder and outside hand, because if this guy is a penetrator, we don't want to just let him go free. So we really want to, the way to kind of work that in the drill, he walks forward, we step flatter. Okay, to get there, we make contact with our outside shoulder, outside hand, and we drive that player this direction. Again, we don't care if we get a little bit of penetration, but we can't let him come scot-free, okay? Other things we can do on those type of teams, we can cheat splits. So we can either cheat splits tighter or deeper or both. So that's another thing we can do. If it's a line player, so somebody who's trying to play up the line, so this defensive lineman we've scouted, the way their philosophy was is they're going to read our block and try to come over the top, okay, which is a well-coached team. Well, now we're actually going to step to the back hip. So still a six-inch step, still a second six-inch step, but now we're aiming to the back and we're actually going to hit with our inside shoulder, and then we're going to bring that hand and turn them to get more surface area as they try to come over top of us. So it's just a quick adjustment we can make. The drill is the same. Aiming point changes, the subtle coaching point changes to kind of work our angles. And we still want to stay low, we still want to bring our hand, we still want to initiate our shoulder. It just changes the shoulder and it changes our first few steps depending on how we read the defense, okay? Second might be a size differential. You know, if you're blocking a very large defensive player, okay, a lot of times you're smaller guards in our system, trying to block a 280-pound guy, will try to come across too quickly. Usually, if they outweigh us, we're going to step a little bit deeper because we're quicker than they are. So we'll use kind of the upfield or the down the line technique. We're stepping a little bit deeper because a lot of times those 300-pounders just take your guard and go and come over the top and make a tackle. So by stepping a little bit deeper, we're going to help ourselves. If it's flipped, let's say our player is bigger and a little slower than their player, then we're almost always going to use a flatter step and get there because we're, you know, we're just basically taking into account what's the advantage and make sure we're helping our player. So we look at the technique of the defensive player. We look at the matchup, okay? And then finally, we look at what is their move after contact. So if I hit this player and he's a spinner or he's a swimmer, or whatever it is, we're going to step a little bit deeper. If we hit this player and he's going to just try to get upfield and get by us, then we're going to step flatter, and that's the adjustment we make off of it. But still the down block drill, that's the only adjustment. So we come out in the spring this year, we'll teach head across, really flat, because that's the harder block to make. As we start to adjust, we'll introduce this drill, and then as we get into season, we'll adjust it week to week. You know, who are we playing? How are we handling this? What are we going to do with it? But hopefully you got something from it. That basically is our first level down block. I've got this drill, second level down block, how we pull kick. All of that stuff is in an offensive line manual. If you'll go to fbcoachsimpson.com, the material section, you can find that, or you can find some video of it with me and Coach Gould walking through it. That's in the material section too, just an offensive line deal. Hopefully you can get something from this. Appreciate you guys checking out this channel. If you would, you'll help me a little bit as I'm trying to grow this channel. If you'll like the video, subscribe to the channel, and I'll try to continue to put out information. Thank you very much.